Welcome friends, in our last lecture we have seen the truss element stiffness matrix in global terms looks like this. K global is equal to AE upon L C square CX minus C square minus CS CS S square minus CS minus S square minus C square minus CS C square CS minus CS minus S square CS S square. This is what we have seen, and we have also seen C means cos theta for that particular member, S is sin theta for that particular member, where theta is the angle measured with respect to global x-axis in anticlockwise direction. Now, it will be very difficult to remember that angle theta is measured in anticlockwise direction, and there can be a confusion. I am drawing a simple structure and explain how the confusion can be there in case of analysis of a truss. The same truss we will take that we have seen for example. This is any truss with three bays, and this is the central bay which is overstiff, which is indeterminate in nature, and this is the truss which is externally also indeterminate, internally also indeterminate. Let us number the elements as AB, CD, EF, and I also know that this is my global x direction, this is my global x direction, this is my global y direction, and I also know that theta is the angle made with respect to global x direction measured in an anticlockwise fashion. Theta is measured in an anticlockwise fashion. Now if I say I want to write coordinates, I want to analyze, I want to write matrix for member AB, then I know member AB is from A to B. I already explained that nomenclature, naming the member, is very important. Member AB is from A to B, global x direction is like this, so the angle theta will be equal to 0. But if I say member BA, if I say member BA, then member BA is like this, global x direction remains the same, this is global x direction. So theta angle is the angle made with respect to global x direction in anticlockwise direction. So theta in this case is 180 degrees. It will be very hard to remember these things in actual practice. Let us consider member AF. Member AF. Member AF, the theta is measured in this direction. This is theta. But for member, this is theta AF. I am writing theta AF. So this is theta AF. But for member FA, if I say member FA, then this is my global x direction. Member FA, theta is to be measured in anticlockwise direction. So this is the theta that I require, that is theta FA. So theta AF and theta FA are two different things. For member FA, that will be theta FA. Theta AF and theta FA are two different things, and every time we need to remember that the angle needs to be measured in anticlockwise direction, angle needs to be measured in anticlockwise direction. So there can be confusion or there can be calculation mistakes in measuring these angles. To avoid those calculation mistakes, I am telling you one simple trick or one simple formula or one simple thing to be remembered. You know, if this is any member AB with A as x1, y1 and B has x2, y2 as coordinates. Let us say this is the two dimensional, this is the member in two dimensional structure. This is a two dimensional structure, member AB, two dimensional structure we are talking. So x1, y1 are the coordinates of the member A, and joint A, and x2, y2 are the coordinates of the joint B. Then I can write cos theta, and let us say this is the angle theta measured with respect to positive global x axis in anticlockwise direction. Cos theta is nothing but x2 minus x1 divided by L, where L is the length of the member AB, L is the length of the member AB, and sin theta is y2 minus y1 divided by L. So this is quite mechanical procedure in which we don't have to remember that we have to calculate the angle anticlockwise. This is the procedure that has taken care that angle is always measured anticlockwise direction, and This is the mechanical procedure in which we can calculate the angles without having to bother whether it is measured in anti-clockwise direction or clockwise direction. So simple thing, cos theta is x2 minus x1 divided by L, L is the length of member, and sin theta is y2 minus y1 divided by L, where we are measuring for member AB. Now if I want to measure for member BA, then B will have x1, y1 and A will have x2, y2, and the formula will be the same. Formula will be the same, cos theta is x2 minus x1 upon L and sin theta is y2 minus y1 upon L. Naturally, tan theta will be sin theta upon cos theta, that is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. I am not going to use this formula, but I am going to use these two formulae for my calculation of cos theta and sin theta, because everywhere in the member I require the value of cos theta and sin theta, and I know theta is the angle measured with respect to positive x-axis in anti-clockwise direction, and that is why these two formulae I am going to use it quite often. Now let us take a simple example. Let us take a simple example, a simple truss which is a triangular truss. Triangle is the simplest form of a truss. Without triangle there cannot be a truss. So minimum three members and three joints. Let us say it is supported like this, okay, and let us say the length of this truss is 15 meter, this is 20 meter. I am saying this is A, this is B and this is C. ABC is a simple truss. Length of this member is 15 meter, 20 meter. Naturally this length will be 25 meters, okay. 3 4 5 triangle. So naturally this will be 25 meters, okay. And then I wish to calculate cos theta and sin theta for every member. Let us say I have decided that I will analyze member AC and I will analyze member CB. I can analyze member BA, I can analyze member CA, I can analyze member CB, no problem. But let us say I have decided I will analyze these three members. So first of all, I will write the joint data. I will write the joint data. Now while writing the joint data, joint x coordinate and its y coordinate. Joint x coordinate and its y coordinate. Now my friends, I will make it a point that the whole structure should lie in the first quadrant. Every time I analyze, I will make it a point that my whole truss is lying in the first quadrant. This is x, this is y, global x y direction. I hope you understand by first quadrant. If this is global x direction, if this is global y direction, then this will be my first quadrant, this will be my second quadrant, this will be the third quadrant, and this will be the fourth quadrant. I will make it a point that all my structure lies in the first quadrant. I will select the coordinate axis in such a fashion that all my structure lies in the first quadrant. Now I will say, now what is the joint A? In this case I have selected this as origin. This is my x-axis, this is my y-axis. So my joint A will have the coordinates 0, 0, since I have selected x as the coordinate. Now what is the coordinate of my joint C? X coordinate is 15, y coordinate is 0. What is the coordinate of my joint B? X coordinate is 0, y coordinate is 20. This is what I am going to write it in joint data. So joint A, x is 0, y is 0. Joint B, x is 0, y is 20, and joint C, x is 15 and y is 0. Simple example to start with, we'll take simple example. Now this is what I have written. What I have done, I have made it a point that all the structure, all my truss lies in the first quadrant. All my truss lies in the first quadrant. I have selected the origin at A so that all the truss lies in the first quadrant. Once I have selected origin at A, I can write the coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinates of all my joints. So this is what I have done. I have written the x coordinate and y coordinate. Now I am analyzing AB, AC and CB. I want to write element stiffness matrix for AB, element stiffness matrix for AC and element stiffness matrix for CB in global terms. In global terms, not in local terms. Local terms, it's very simple. AE upon L, 10 minus 10. Okay, but I don't want to write in local terms. I want to write it in global terms. So that's why I need to find out C and S for AB, C and S for AC, C and S for CB. I want to find out cos theta and sin theta. To avoid complications, to avoid mistakes in calculations, I have just determined that I will follow a mechanical procedure in which all my truss should lie in a first quadrant, and I can measure, I can write the coordinates of joint A and joint B. And I know the formula cos theta is x2 minus x1 divided by L, sin theta is y2 minus y1 divided by L. Now I am writing the member data. Next step, I will be writing member data. So member data will be somewhat like this. Member length C S C square C S S square. These are the only coordinates we need to write in global stiffness matrix for any element. Member L C S C square C S and S square. So my first member is AB. Length of member AB is 20 meters. I am writing length in meters. Length is 20 meters. Now I am calculating for member AB. I am calculating C. What is the formula for now? I am saying, look at this. Member AB. I am not taking member BA. Member AB. So what is the coordinate of A? A is 0, 0. And B is 0, 20. Now where is x1, y1? Since it is member AB, this is x1, this is y1, this is x2, this is y2. We have discussed, if it would have been member BA, then this would have been x1, y1 and this would have been x2, y2. Now I am writing C, that is cos theta for member AB. Cos theta for member AB is x2 minus x1 divided by L. So 0 minus 0 divided by 20, that is equal to 0. And sin theta S is y2 minus y1, that is 20 minus 0 divided by 20. Sin theta is 1. So I am writing cos theta 0, sin theta 1, cos square 0, cos sine 0, sin square 1. Now my friends, pay attention to member AB. Look at this. Now what is the angle? Angle AB, what is theta for AB? If I measure it in anticlockwise direction, theta is equal to 90 degrees. Everybody agree? Theta is equal to 90 degrees. I have measured with respect to positive x-axis in global direction in an anticlockwise fashion. So for member AB, theta is 90 degrees. In that case, what is cos 90? Cos 90 is 0 and sin 90 is equal to 1. That is what exactly we are getting. Cos 90 is 0, sin 90 1. So our procedure is exactly correct. So now consider, if I say member BA. Now let's say if I say member BA, again coordinates will not change. A will be 0, 0, B will be 0, 20, right? But x1, y1 and x2, y2 will change. Since I am calculating BA, this will be x1, y1, this will be x2, y2. And now my C for BA is x2 minus x1, 0 minus 0 divided by 20, that is equal to 0, all right. But my sign is y2 minus y1, 0 minus 20 divided by 20, that is equal to minus 1. Now consider this, what is BA member? What is the angle made by the BA member with respect to positive global x-axis? This is my positive global x-axis. Angle made with respect, made by member BA with respect to positive global x-axis is this angle in anticlockwise fashion, that is 270 degrees. And then I know cos 270 degrees is equal to 0 and sin 270 degrees is equal to minus 1. That is what I am getting over here. That is what I am getting, 0 and minus 1. So this procedure is foolproof. This procedure is completely correct. And we don't have to bother whether we are measuring the angle in clockwise direction or anticlockwise direction. Because it is seen, the students commit some mistake in a hurry. They calculate the angle in anticlockwise fashion or clockwise fashion and write C and S. It is not that simple. That is why let us follow the mechanical procedure. Joint data, joint coordinates. The coordinates are written by putting all the structure in the first quadrant like this. I have put all the structure in the first quadrant and now I am writing the formula. Now for member, next member is AC. I know next member AC is oriented in global x direction. Theta is equal to 0. Therefore cos theta will be equal to 1 and sin theta will be equal to 0. Let us see whether it is satisfying. Length of member AC is 15 meters. Now AC. What is coordinate of A? Coordinate of A is 0, 0 and coordinate of C is 15, 0. Now, since I am measuring AC, A will be x1, y1, c will be x2 y2. So my cos theta that will be equal to x2 minus x1 divided by l, that is equal to 15 minus 0 divided by 15, length of AC is 15, so that is equal to 1, and sin theta will be y2 minus y1 divided by l, that is equal to 0 minus 0 divided by 15, that is equal to 0. That is what we have anticipated. Since AC is oriented in global x direction, theta is 0, so cos theta should be equal to 1 and sin theta should be equal to 0. That is what I am writing, cos theta 1, sin theta 0. Now once I have written cos theta and sin theta, cos square is 1, cos sine is 0 and sine square is 0. This is what I have written for member AC. Now for member, next member is CB. I have calculated member CB. I am writing CB, C as 15, 0 and B as 0, 20. Since I am measuring CB, C will have the coordinates x1, y1 and B will have coordinates x2, y2. Since I am measuring CB, C will have coordinates x1, y1 and B will have coordinates x2, y2. Now I am calculating cos theta is equal to x2 minus x1 divided by L. Now length of CB is equal to 25 meters, I know it. So x2 minus x1, that is 0 minus 15 divided by 25, that is equal to minus 15 by 25, that is minus 3 by 5. And sine theta will be y2 minus y1 upon L, that is equal to 20 minus 0 divided by 25, that is equal to 20 upon 25, that is equal to 4 by 5. Now friends, pay attention, this CB member, if I consider C as origin, this CB member is lying in second quadrant. In second quadrant, cos is negative and sine is positive, and that is why I am getting the answers. So I am writing the answers over here. So for member CB, length is 25 meters, cos theta is minus 3 by 5, that is minus 0.6, and sin theta 4 by 5, 0.8. So cos square is 0.36, cos into sin, that is minus 0.48, and sin square 0.64. This is how I am going to analyze my joints. This is how I am going to write my structure data, member data and my joint data without having to bother what is the angle made with respect to positive x-axis. If I measure this angle measured with respect to positive x-axis, it is definitely more than 90, less than 180, and that is why the cos has to be negative and sine has to be positive. For any angle more than 90 and less than 180, cos is negative, sine is positive, and that is what I am getting over here by simply doing mathematical calculations, mechanical calculations. Cos theta is equal to x2 minus x1 and sin theta is equal to y2 minus y1, where x1, y1 are the coordinates of the first point and x2, y2 are the coordinates of the second point. So measuring, naming the members, whether I am naming the member CB or BC, it makes a lot of difference. Whether I am naming the member AC or CA, it makes a lot of difference. So naming the member will make a lot of difference in our calculation of truss data in case of analysis of indeterminate truss. I hope you have understood the procedure of calculation of joint data and member data. In our next discussion, we will analyze one full-fledged problem regarding analysis of indeterminate truss using truss element stiffness matrix. Thank you.